In the past, when I made a video about describing my entry-level position as a mechanical engineer, I briefly mentioned that at some point I got to work at a shipyard for a couple of months down in Charleston, South Carolina, as an assistant port engineer. I actually got to go on site. I went to South Carolina for a couple of months and actually ended up working on a ship. And that was very, very insightful. And this is going to be a video that I'm going to make on its own, because this was a whole new experience. If you haven't watched that video, I highly suggest you go watch it so you get an insight on what an entry-level mechanical engineering position is like, of course, after watching this video. But today, I wanted to get into detail of what I actually did during my rotation as an assistant port engineer. I wanted to show you another engineering field that perhaps is not that common or that many engineers don't know about, but that could be fun, and yes, also profitable due to the amount of overtime that you could pull off. All right, so first things first, we are going to be going over the basics of a port engineer, what it is, what it does, and I'm going to walk you through my day as a port engineer. Now, this is going to be based on my experience as an assistant port engineer, but since I was the eyes and ears of the port engineer himself, I definitely got a chance to observe what my port engineer did and what his day entailed in general. And so I'm making this video. So what is a port engineer anyway? If it's the first time you heard of it, a port engineer is someone who is in charge of all the engineering support for a ship and its systems during maintenance periods. Think about this. When the ship pulls into a port and it needs work done, port engineers lead the effort of the work that needs to take place, including new equipment, installation or removals, and anything that involves maintenance. Now, there is a lot of things that need to be taken into account that happen behind the scenes when it comes to being a port engineer, such as dealing with budgets, scheduling, negotiations, and even contract arrangements. A port engineer is also the technical point of contact for everything happening on the ship, and also deals with the sponsor, who is the organization that runs the ship and funds all its voyages. Every time there is unexpected work that needs to be done, or you find out things are worse than imagined, the port engineer deals with tough phone calls communicating the bad news to the people who have to pay for the work to be done. So yes, a port engineer position could be tough from that perspective. At the end of the day, port engineers make sure the equipment performs as expected, and the ship is ready to go for another couple of months until its next maintenance period, or as we call it in the naval industry, its next availability. Now, you might be asking yourself, what kind of systems do port engineers deal with? Electrical, mechanical? And that's a great question. And the answer is both. And yes, actually, more than that. Port engineers deal with all systems aboard the ship, and so they have to have a general idea of how all of them work, or at least learn how they work, and heavily rely on the experts they deal with. Some of the systems they are involved with are electrical, mechanical, and dealing with power generation, water making, sewage systems, entertainment, GPSs, fire control, electronics, low and high pressure air systems, hydraulic systems, welding, machining, rigging. They have a lot of systems to take care of, and it can be a bit overwhelming in the beginning of your journey. This is when I learned how ships are amazing engineering marvels, as they're basically like floating cities. They generate their own power, they make their own water, run their own sewage, make their own food, and even have their own medical facilities. So now that we have a basic understanding and general idea of what a port engineer is and what it does, let's look at one day in the life when I was part of the port engineering team in Charleston, South Carolina. So I'm going to start with the schedule. Keep in mind that I was only there to support one ship for one availability, and so I worked every day for 2 months with the exception of 2 days. I took 2 days off in 2 months or so, and believe it or not, that's not very uncommon. I was working at least 10 to 12 hour days, and sometimes even 14. There was a lot of overtime available, and so, as I will talk about later, the money was awesome. The schedule consisted of working Monday through Sunday. Well, you didn't have to go in on weekends, but I honestly felt that I needed to be there helping out, since that's the only reason I was there. I didn't have any other weekend plans or commitments. When it comes to the day itself and what it entailed, I'll go over the highlights and usual workday breakdown. So in the beginning, I will usually get to work early and start the day around 5:30 or 6 a.m. That's when you start checking the emails, prepare the work to be discussed during the early stand-up meeting, and of course, get coffee, talk, socialize. It wasn't always 100% work. A couple of hours later, at approximately 8 a.m., we had a daily safety and a stand-up meeting, which was basically a meeting to talk about the plans for the day. This took place Monday to Friday and not on weekends. This is a meeting where we would talk about safety precautions, we would talk about any type of announcements, issues, the schedule for the project, issues with contractors and getting things done, perhaps any delays with the work taking place, any scheduled inspections, tests, and meetings that needed to be attended or covered throughout the day. And on top of that, I would also attend other unexpected calls for the port engineer and make decisions on his behalf whenever that was needed. Sometimes I had to go back and discuss certain things with a port engineer because, well, mistakes could be expensive, especially if the instructions you give out are not part of the previously agreed upon contract. And so after the stand-up meeting, which usually lasted about an hour, the rest of the day would be spent something like this. We'll be talking with welders, electricians, machinists, contractors, discussing and making decisions on what to do. One of the things that I had to keep in mind was that if I wasn't sure on what to do, I always had to discuss it with the team. I was only 25 years old around this point, and so my experience was very limited then. And it's limited now, but it was even more limited then. Second thing we would do throughout the day would be attending tests and inspections and different parts of the systems of the ship. We would attend inspections in fuel tanks, diesel engines, generators, welds, installation of new equipment, whether it was mechanical or electrical. We will inspect and go check on the work being done on pumps, boilers, switchboards, steam valves, even dealing with GPSs and fire control systems. Like I said, the port engineer position is very, very involved, and you'll be involved with pretty much everything that's taking place on the ship. At the end of the day, when things started to slow down, I would usually work around with the port engineer himself, just double checking the ongoing and completed work around the ship, just to make sure things were going well as well. Around 5 p.m. or so, I would usually head home, hump some dinner, go to the gym, and then repeat the next day. So that was basically one day in my life as a port engineer. But now, let's talk about the money. When it comes to the money itself, I want to say that it was awesome. I really enjoyed the additional money that came from working additional hours and overtime. I don't want to get into too much detail here, but let's just say that in 2 months, I made an additional $10,000 on top of my usual base salary. And at 25 years old, making approximately $60,000 a year, that was a big deal. But if you want to get an idea of how much port engineers make themselves, it usually ranges between $80,000 or $90,000, depending on your industry and your salary structure. You may also be eligible for bonuses or additional compensation. So if you're interested in that, look at your specific situation in the company if you'd like to find out more. So what are some takeaways from this video, other than getting a bit of insight into one day in the life of a port engineer? Well, there's a few things that I want you to take away from here, but the main thing is that as an engineer in general, no matter what field you're on, you won't always know it all, and you must work with your team to figure things out and make things happen. Personally, as someone who was doing it for the first time as an assistant port engineer, I heavily relied on experts. I had a lot of responsibility because of my decision-making ability. And so I was always asking questions to the people who were doing things for a living. At the same time, I also had to be careful not only with the technical instructions I was given, but also with the regulations of the contract. I had to make sure that what I was instructing was within the guidelines of the contract and I wasn't telling the workers to do additional work. This was very important and crucial because if I gave instructions that I was not supposed to, or that were not part of the contract, that could end up being very costly. I had to be aware of what was and what was not included in the contract. And as an engineer, you will deal with contracts along your journey. The contract is basically what tells you what to do, what technical requirements you must meet, what budget, your deadlines, and deliverables you will have for your respective project. So pay attention to the contract. But if you are a little nervous about this, don't fear. In most instances, in most companies, I want to say, companies assign a contract specialist that will help engineers review the technical side of the contract. So just be aware of that. Another takeaway from this video for you is that as a port engineer, you will be dealing with multiple disciplines and you must learn to communicate and rely on other people. So you must be humble, ask questions if you're not sure. Sometimes you just have to make a decision and recommendation and go with it. And who knows, take the heat if it's your fault, if something goes wrong. And this is something that I learned along the way because I definitely made mistakes along the way as my assistant port engineering journey. So with everything that I said, if you are interested in becoming a port engineer or would like to find out more details about it, here are some high-level tips to become one. Usually, port engineers have a marine engineering degree, but many of the ones I've worked with in the past have either had mechanical or electrical engineering backgrounds, and I've honestly seen even civil engineers be port engineers. And this is, I think, because port engineers deal with lots of disciplines anyway. So the background of the port engineer is usually just engineering. As long as you have an engineering background, that basically shows that you could adapt to learn other fields. Sure, marine engineering would be ideal, but just make sure you check with your specific company and their job requirements. Another tip that you can use is to look for companies into the naval industry. Since port engineers work at ports, then look for companies that deal with sea transportation or something along those lines. If you have a project management background, I think this could be very beneficial and helpful because as a port engineer, you will be dealing with schedule, budgeting, technical requirements, and even contracts. So I think a project management background could help greatly. Now, when it comes to certifications for this position, there are certainly some certifications out there that you could use, but I highly encourage you to look into the company and see if you actually do need one. So there you go. That's basically what a day in the life of a port engineer is like, and also a little bit of insight into the port engineering world, if that's something that you would be interested in. At the end of the day, here's one more option I think can be very lucrative and definitely high-paced if you like working with your hands and with multiple disciplines and leading teams. I think that a port engineer position would be very good for you. If you like this video, make sure that you give it a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss future videos like this. So with that being said, I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you for watching. Peace.